Pointers in C++. What is the use of pointers in object-oriented programming language and how can we implement a program with the help of pointers? Hello everyone, I'm Sukanya from GoEduHub Technologies and in this video we are going to discuss about pointers in C++. Pointers is one of the key aspects of C++ language similar to that of C. As we know, pointers unique offer an approach to handle data in C and C++ both. Now, declaration and initialization of pointer. So, declaration of pointer is based on data type and the variable it points to. So, the syntax is data type, then with the help of asterisk sign, you're going to name that pointer variable. Here, pointer variable is the name of the pointer and the data type refers to one of which it's valid in C++ data types. The data type is allowed by an asterisk symbol which distinguishes a pointer variable from the other variables to the compiler. Otherwise, compiler would treat the pointer variable similar to the other variables of the program. So just to maintain another distinguish and the compiler should not get, you know, error or the compilation error, we use the asterisk sign. We can allocate asterisk sign immediately before the pointer variable or between the data type or the pointer variable or immediately after the data type also. It would not cause any effect in the execution. That means you can do like this type of initialization also just after the pointer initialization before or similarly after the variable data type declaration. Here PTR is the pointer variable which points to an integer variable, integer data type. Next is initialization of pointer. How can we initialize? We have seen the declaration and next how can we initialize? So the pointer variable should contain the memory location of any variable of its own type. In the above example of pointer, PTR should contain memory location of an integer variable. We can initialize a pointer variable as follows, which we have seen that int asterisk symbol PTR, this is the declaration. Then int a is the variable created and then PTR is actually initialized. Now this is initialization with the help of ampersand sign and a. The pointer variable PTR contains the address of which variable? A variable. This is the scene that the initialization, it is containing the address of a variable. Here we have use ampersand to retrieve the address of that particular variable a. What is the address in the memory of a program or given to this particular variable a? So here is a program, you can see that very simple program, there is just a variable int a and then a pointer is declared and then it is initialized. That pointer is having the address of the a variable and the a variable address is firstly printed and then after increment the value of address a, that after increment what is the value of that pointer, so that is incremented with 2 and then what is the next address of that variable. So this is how pointers, you can get clear with how it is different from another variable and how the address gets incremented of that particular with the help of pointer variable. So what is the basic use of pointer? Pointer variable actually contains the address of variable of any particular variable which is being initialized with the pointer PTR or any name you want to give to your pointer variable. So let us firstly write this program and see that what is the address and what is the address after incrementing of that variable a with the help of pointers. So here you can see that I have written the program which I have explained you and it is firstly going to print the address of a and then the address after incrementing, that is incrementation is in with plus 2, then it is going to print the address of that particular pointer which is storing the memory or the address of the variable a. As I execute this program, you can see that the address is particularly this is it is mentioned and then after increment the address is also mentioned over here. This is the address which is in the memory of the particular program, that what it has given in the stack memory, that which memory is to be initialized. So this is the address of that particular memory block of the program which is being given to the variable a and pointer reflects to that particular address of that variable. So in this video we have studied about pointers, how can we initialize a pointer and then how can we use that particular pointer in the programming logic. For more programs of object-oriented programming, we will be looking into upcoming videos. Thank you.